Hello, this is Lakshmi Kantiwari. In this tutorial, we will learn about the ARM architecture. ARM is also known as an advanced RISC machine. This processor is completely based on the RISC architecture. There is a number of advantages of RISC over the CISC. RISC approach reduces the cost of hardware and it produces less heat than the traditional 86 architecture, and also it is power efficient. RISC architecture is also known as a load store architecture. It means CPU cannot directly perform memory operation. For a memory operation, microcontroller have to first load desired memory location content in a register. Then after CPU operation, it can store the result through a general purpose registers. ARM Holdings does not manufacture products. It only develops the instruction set and architectures for ARM-based product. Then it sells it in the form of the IP to the semiconductor manufacturing company like Texas Instruments, Philips, and the ST Microelectronics. ARM microcontroller is the most widely used microcontroller in the world. The company periodically releases update to its core, and the current core for the ARM holding supports 64-bit address space and the 64-bit arithmetic. ARM version 8 architecture announced in October 2011 adds support for 64-bit address space and the 64-bit arithmetic instruction for the ARM holding core have 32-bit wide fixed length instructions, but a later version of the architectures also support a variable length instruction set that provide both 32 and the 16-bit wide instructions for a improved code density. Currently, ARM processor microcontroller have 32-bit as well as a 64-bit architecture. Throughout this tutorial, I use byte, it means 8-bit, half word means 16-bit, and the word means 32-bit. There are actually three instruction set in a modern ARM cores, such as a version 7 core A8, M3 and R4, and version 8 cores such as M7. We have a thumb, thumb 2 and the ARM. So the one core in particular, the ARM Cortex M3, executes only the Cortex, executes only the Thumb 2 code and not ARM code. All Thumb 2 instructions are 16-bit long. I don't worry about the thumb instructions. And for time being, just remember it. I will cover thumb and the ARM instruction set in a next tutorial. There is another type of instruction set, which is also known as a Java bytecode. Java bytecode are 8-bit instructions designed to be the architecture independent, but in a further tutorial, we will only discuss about the thumb and the ARM instruction set. ARM have three series of microcontroller, Cortex-A, Cortex-R and the Cortex-M series, where A means application specific microcontroller such as in smartphones, and R means a real-time specific microcontroller used in a space and the missile applications. And the last one, which is mostly used in a general purpose application, such as a motor control, LED and the LCD interfaces. Throughout the whole tutorial series, we only discuss about the ARM Cortex-M series microcontrollers. This ARM Cortex-M series microcontroller have four different subseries of microcontrollers. They are a Cortex-M0, M0+, Cortex-M1, Cortex-M3 and the Cortex-M4, and the recently Cortex-M7. The interesting thing is that all microcontrollers are consistently based on a 32-bit processor architectures. However, few of them are using 16-bit thumb instruction set, and the rest of them are using both thumb and the ARM instruction set, and the Cortex-M7 is based on the 64-bit architecture set. The ARM Cortex-M0 is mostly preferred where our requirement is low power and the lowest cost. It has almost all general features of microcontroller. It has a nested vector interrupt controller, which is also known as a NVIC. The NVIC is tightly coupled to the processor core, and this facilitates low latency exception processing. And the main feature includes a configurable number of external interrupts from 1 to 240 available, but actual number of interrupts on hardware depends on the chip manufacturer. It has a configurable number of bits of priority from 3 to 8 bits. It also supports level and the pulse interrupt. It also supports the dynamic reprioritization of the interrupts. It can also do priority grouping, and last but not least, processor state automatically saved on an interrupt entry and restored on the interrupt exit. Even with no instruction overhead, all these things processor do in a background. Another important feature is wake up interrupt controller, which is also known as a WIC. Interface wake up interrupt controller can detect an interrupt and wake the processor even from the deep sleep mode, where the processor is resting in a minimum power consumption mode. Wireless sensor networking uses this feature for the lowest possible power consumption, where we need data only in some interval, such as in 10 seconds or it can be the 1 minute also. Cortex M0 uses advanced high performance bus, that is the AHB lit interface. However, AHB is a bus protocol with a fixed pipeline between an address control and the data pages. It only supports a subset of the functionality provided by the advanced microcontroller bus architecture AXI protocol. For the sake of your introductory information, I want to tell you AMBA is a family of a protocol specification that describes a strategy for the interconnect. It is the ARM open standard for on-chip buses. It is an on-chip bus specification that details a strategy for the interconnection and the management of a functional block within a chip. Another important feature is a data watch point and the breakpoint. It is a feature of a debug unit which is present on chip. In a debug mode, we can monitor the state of the processor in each and every clock cycle. Don't worry about the detailed explanation of these terms. We will definitely have a look in couple of next tutorial. There are two debug access ports generally present in all ARM devices. They are single wire debug unit and the JTAG unit. Now let's move for another subseries of Cortex-M processor. It is a Cortex-M0 Plus. ARM Cortex-M0 Plus is a superset of the Cortex-M0 processor. In terms of instruction set, that means the ARM Cortex-M0 instruction set is 100% compatible with the ARM Cortex-M0 Plus processor. ARM Limited added some of new features in ARM Cortex-M0 Plus over the M0 series, such as a memory protection unit, low latency input-output interfaces, and the microtrace buffer. Memory protection unit enables you to partition memory into regions and the set individual protection attributes for each region. And also you can partition memory address space into the 16 region of a variable size. For beginner, it is not necessary to cover all aspects of the memory protection unit. ARM Cortex-M0 Plus low latency input-output interface provides a Harvard-like access to the peripheral and improves over cycle efficiency for input-output access. And last one is a microtrace buffer. The name microtrace buffer already indicate that what is the behind this tracing method. ARM has added support in the silicon which logs trace information in a memory buffer in RAM. If configured properly, a tool like a Kale will read the buffer in RAM and process the information. The good thing with the MTB is the location in RAM and the size is user configurable. It is simply a buffer somewhere in the RAM. Using the MTB trace does not need any special hardware. A normal debug connection like OpenSDK is good enough for debugging. ARM Cortex-M3 added a more feature in a Cortex-M0 subseries processor. The main feature of this processor is one cycle 32-bit hardware multiply, 2 to 12 cycle 32-bit hardware divide, and the saturated math support. 3-stage pipeline with branch speculation, only 12 cycle interrupt latency, and 1.25D MIPS per megahertz high performance. And another feature is ITM and the ETM trace. Cortex-M3 is performance efficient and have a lot of feature than a predecessor. Let's have a look on the Cortex-M4 processor. Conceptually, the Cortex-M4 is a Cortex-M3 plus DSP instructions and also optional floating point unit on chip. And if core contains a floating point unit, then it is known as a Cortex-M4 F-core. Otherwise, it is only a Cortex-M4 microcontroller. The main feature of this microcontroller is its DSP extension have a single cycle 16 and a 32-bit MAC. And the MAC is a multiply and the accumulation operation. MAC operation is very efficient in a digital filter design, and also it has a single cycle dual 16-bit MAC operation or 8 to 16-bit SIMD single instruction a multiple data arithmetic operation. Now I am going to stop this tutorial here, and if you have any question, please comment below and subscribe it for more video tutorials.